Indonesia, the Philippines, Malaysia. Three of the most beautiful and unique countries in the world. Welcome back to the Travel Bible. In this video, we will compare three of my favorite countries in the world: Indonesia, the Philippines, and Malaysia, each as unique and wonderful as the next. We will take a look at their geography, demographics, economy, and quality of living. Then, once you've watched the video, we will ask you which one you'd live in, which one you'd visit, and which one you'd avoid. So sit back and enjoy. Let's start by looking at their geography. First, let's take a look at the percentage of their land that is covered by forests. Forests have a key role in removing pollutants and cleansing the air and supporting incredible animals. To my surprise, the winner here is Malaysia with 62%, followed by Indonesia with 52%, and then the Philippines with 26%. I personally would have thought that Indonesia would have won this. Now, let's take a look at the amount of coastline these countries have. Again, the more here, the better. So, Indonesia is the clear winner here with nearly 58,000 kilometers of coastline, followed by the Philippines with 36,000, and in third place, Malaysia with a minuscule 4,600. So the winner here is Indonesia. And finally, for geography, let's take a look at their total surface area. Again, the higher here, the better. So Indonesia has an incredible 1.9 million kilometers squared, making it the 15th biggest country in the world. Next, we have Malaysia with 330,000, and then just behind, we have the Philippines with 300,000. Again, this was a huge surprise to me. I would have thought the Philippines was a much bigger country than Malaysia. Okay, cool. So now let's look at demographics. So first, we'll take a look at the life expectancy at birth for these three countries. This metric reflects the overall quality of life for a country. So Malaysia clearly wins this one with 75.4, putting it in the top 42% of countries in the world. Then we have Indonesia just behind at 73.2, putting it at the top 51% in the world. And then in third place, we have the Philippines at 69.6, putting it in the top 59% countries of the world. For cigarettes smoked per capita, Indonesia is actually the 30th highest in the world. I wonder if this has a big impact on the average life expectancy. To put it in perspective, Malaysia sits at 107th in the world. Now, let's take a look at the population of these countries. So Indonesia is a clear winner here, with roughly 270 million people, making it the fourth most populated country in the world. Next, we have the Philippines with roughly 110 million, making it the 13th highest populated country in the world. And finally, Malaysia with a modest 33 million, putting it in 45th place, just behind Angola and just above Mozambique. And finally, let's take a look at the population density of these three countries. The lower here, the better. Population density shows how cramped or spread out inhabitants are. Cities or countries with high population densities can be considered overpopulated, which can be a problem if the infrastructure is undeveloped. So Malaysia takes the win here with 99 people per kilometer squared, then Indonesia with 141, and then the Philippines with 360. So let's move on to the economy. First, we'll look at the unemployment rate of these three countries. Low employment rate indicates better career opportunities and economic growth. So Malaysia takes a clear win here with 3.4%. Then Indonesia with 5.4, and then finally the Philippines with 5.7. Now let's look at the GDP. The GDP per capita is calculated by dividing the total GDP by the number of people living in the country. A higher GDP per capita indicates a superior standard of living. There is an absolute clear winner here, Malaysia at $32,500, followed by Indonesia with $14,000, and then in third place the Philippines with $9,500. So it has two clear wins for Malaysia. And finally, for economy, let's take a look at these countries' education expenditures. The higher here, the better, as the more you invest into education, the more skilled workers you are likely to produce. So again, Malaysia takes a clear win here, with 4.7% of their GDP being spent on education. Then Indonesia, and then the Philippines, with 3.6% and 2.7% respectively. And finally, let's finish off with a quality of living, one of the most important factors when looking at how great a country is. So let's look at the adult obesity rate. Astonishingly, 15.6% of adults in Malaysia are classed as obese, compared to 6.9% in Indonesia and then 6.4% in the Philippines, giving the Philippines the clear win here. Now, let's look at physicians per 1,000 people. According to the World Health Organization, there should be more than 2.3 health workers per 1,000 people in order to cover the primary healthcare needs. So Malaysia has 1.51, Indonesia 0.38, and the Philippines 1.28. So Malaysia takes the win here. And let's now end the video by looking at the percentage of people below the poverty line. Of course, the lower here, the better. There is an absolute clear winner here again. So Malaysia with 3.8%, followed by Indonesia with 11%, and then finally the Philippines with 21.6%. So now it's your turn. Let us know in the comments below which one you'd live in, which one you'd visit, and which one you'd avoid, and why. We can't wait to read your comments. And while you're there, let us know which cities or countries we should do next. I would personally live in Malaysia because it has the highest quality of living. I've never been to the Philippines, but I've always wanted to go, so I'd visit there, and then I'd have to avoid Indonesia because I've already been there before. If you enjoyed the video or you learned something new, a like and a sub to the channel would be marvelous. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.